Hey guys, I'm Claudia McLeod, and welcome back to another episode of Mustang Magazine. We've got some more interesting and exciting stories to share with you guys, so let's get started. First on today's show, we'll be starting our fitness segment. Here's Matthew Malave with more details on how to stay fit and have fun while doing it.
So you never even heard of CrossFit. Fact is, neither have I. So we came here to CrossFit Sobro to give you a first inside look.
CrossFit is a spontaneous way to get fit. It is a mixture of weightlifting and cardio exercise. The exercises are intense, but people really enjoy doing it. CrossFit Sobro students are incredibly passionate about this workout. Everyone works as a team to achieve a common goal.
Yeah, overall, they kind of cheer you as you run, as you carry the kettlebells.
Yeah, it's like, encouragement. Come on, let's go. It's not like a typical gym.
The CrossFit Sobro community is like one big happy family. Trainers help their students progress to higher levels of fitness. Various methods are used to help the students gain the ability to perform on higher levels. Jose, one of the trainers, tells us what he likes to see in a person.
So what I like seeing is how can we untap that athletic potential, and part of it is that I really love teaching, so I like to get the best out of everyone.
CrossFit Sobro prices come out to $185 a month for adults, but for students under 18, it comes out to $100.
Members here that are above, let's say 21, 22, always tell me the same thing. I wish we would have had that when we were kids. We would have them when we were 10, 11, 12.
The result of CrossFit is absolutely amazing. Frazar lost a tremendous amount of weight in just one third of the year.
Now you have a taste of what CrossFit is. Do you think you have everyone it takes to take the challenge? Go directly to our Facebook page to find out more information about CrossFit and where you can you go. Here from CrossFit Sobro, I'm Matt Malave reporting from Truman Magazine.
Don't go yet. We have one more story for you after this break.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down, and I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood, I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I whistled for a cab, and when it came near, the license plate said fresh and it had dice in the mirror. If anything, I can say that this cab was rare, but I thought, man, forget it, yo, home to Bel Air. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8 and I yelled to the cabbie, "Yo, home, smell you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel Air.
We often think we know everything about a person because we spend 8 hours a day, 5 days a week with them. But little do we know that we often really don't know as much as we think we do. One teen in particular may have more to his story than meets the eye. Here is Stephanie with the story.
Andre Villanueva is just another average teen that you see walking in the hallways at school. Like any other student, he struggles in his math and science classes, although his love for the arts causes him to thrive in his theater class.
Andre, it's over.
What do you mean it's over? I never did anything to you. All I ever do is try to love you.
He doesn't just stop there, because when Andre leaves school, he takes his creativity elsewhere.
Stand clear of the closing doors, please.
I started dancing because I actually liked it. And my uncles, they was teaching me, they wanted to teach me something new. Like, I was really young at the time. So they was like, you know, we like to dance, so why not teach, you know, little man how to dance. Yeah. I love music, so, you know, and being able to go with the music at the same time while you're dancing and, you know, just having people watch you, the attention you get from it, you know, because not everybody could dance. So when you have that gift, you know, It's a good thing.
Based on his interest in the arts, I wanted to know if he considered it as an escape from his reality. And he responded,
not really, because my problems are still there at the end of the day, you know? But dancing, it's more of like a relief.
With that being said, I dug deeper to find out more about what he was trying to escape and found something rather unexpected.
I was in school, I was trying to play sports. I wanted to play football, actually. And I went to the nurse, you know, you had to get a physical and everything before, you know, you actually become on the team. And then she was listening to my heart, and then she said she had heard a heart murmur.
It's a very big red flag, something that you stop right then and there and you say, no, you're definitely not getting clearance for any activity until we look into what's going on.
Then she gave me referrals to professionals, and then I went to the professionals, and they did the, I think, ultrasound on my chest, and they actually seen that it was a hole in my chest. So then they told me that I had to get a heart surgery. I couldn't believe it at first. I was like, what? You know, because my dad actually had a heart surgery, and I see the way his chest looked, and you know, I didn't really like it.
One, two, three, let it out.
I got this scar that I don't really like, you know. It kind of, I'm not going to lie to you, it brought an insecurity to me now, because I'm not really that free to take off my shirt like that anymore.
But most might argue that a chest scar is a small price to pay for a second chance at life.
They told me that, like, I had this hole in my heart since I was born, so it's gotten bigger through the years, and they actually told me, like, we're surprised that heart failure hasn't happened sooner. So now I'm actually thankful for that, because who knows what could have possibly happened.
In spite of his recent health condition, Andre refuses to let it impede upon his passion for the arts.
Yeah, I still do it to this day, but I'm not able to do it that much. Like, we have a whole routine, you know? Everyone do their own solo, you know? Everyone has their own separate dance from the dance itself, and I'm not able to do mine anymore.
Today, Andre continues to do what he loves, and he was even kind enough to demonstrate his talent. Life takes dark turns. We can see that in Andre's case. Yet although the dark turns are difficult to overcome, we should all come out dancing on the other side. This is Stephanie Rodriguez reporting from Truman Media.
That's all the time we have. We hope you enjoyed. See you next time on Mustang Magazine.